here from Shark Fan down at the San Diego shop for a couple of days. And while here, we received some new gear. And one that we've been waiting on since ICAST. It's taken a while. Seeker introduced a new series of rods at ICAST that caught a lot of people by surprise. Those who follow the net kind of had a little background of what was going on. But basically, they introduced a new series called the Bushido series of rods. These are a much welcomed departure for Seeker. These rods incorporate a very high-end blank that's produced overseas. The wrapping of the first generation of these rods was all done here in Long Beach. In the future production, they'll manufacture these rods overseas as well. The first grouping of them, they wanted to absolutely have full control over the pieces. They are the distributor for this blank as well. And they basically went to town. I guess Randy was turned loose over there at Seeker. Between Randy and Darren, they really, really pulled the stops and came up with some things that very, very refreshing to see. The first thing you'll notice with these rods, with this blank, is how incredibly light they are. This is a light line series. They range anywhere from appropriate for, say, 6 pound application through 25 pound applications. Wonderful bend to these things, but the lightness, I can't really show that on video other than to say it's a feather light rod. They use a split grip and the cork that also cuts down the weight. Obviously, it's a blank through butt design. They do these in spinning form as well as conventional form. All the conventional rods incorporate the same sort of split grip, which has become quite popular. Look at this thing, it's light. And a trigger, of course. So for good feel. So we have them in conventional as well as spinning form. But I've got to draw your attention, and I don't know if this camera is going to focus well enough to do that, on the guides that are being used. Throughout the rod, you'll see we're making use of the little tiny micro guides. Very, very small, all the way up. Okay. But that most important guide of all is the one down here, the first guide. And this is using what has been a show winner at ICAST and then also at FTAX, which is the European Tackle Show, and in Asia, in the China Tackle Show. This is a neat, neat thing that we've seen, at the shows and seen incorporated. I don't know of any production rods that use this microwave technology yet. But what happens when the line shoots through, all of a sudden, it's focused into a smaller ringlet. And that's where it goes throughout the rest of the guides. Now, on first blush, you might say, oh my gosh, that's going to restrict the casting. What it winds up doing is increasing the velocity, and so you could gain 20% on your casting distance. It's amazing what the difference is. To cast one is to be a believer. It truly makes a difference. Think about it in terms of pipe, plumbing. We're going to talk fishing and plumbing at the same content. I don't know. But even in pipes, let's say you've got a certain diameter pipe, and you're flushing water through it. What happens if you go from, let's say, a 2-inch diameter pipe down to a 1-inch or a 1/2-inch diameter pipe? What happens? The velocity increases. All of a sudden, that water is not just running out of the pipe, it is shooting out of the pipe. And that's exactly what happens with these stinking guides. It's ridiculous to see it. But all if you see some of the photographs that have been taken of line coming through a standard guide, you get this big coiling effect as it goes through. This takes that big coil that comes off, say, a spinning reel or even a conventional reel to a certain extent and makes that small. So all of a sudden that energy, instead of wobbling through, goes shooting straight through. Net result, greater long distance for your casting and less incidence of wind knots, which is a big complaint of guys that are fishing braid, is getting the wind knots in the braided line. This will reduce that and it'll gain you casting distance. Pretty neat stuff. The use of micro guides, delightful, And here's the other thing that kind of is neat, and I have to say, our friends at Toro Tamer were on the money with this one. Toro Tamer produces a 20 and 30 pound 16 strand hollow core gel spun line. 16 strands, 20 pound and 30 pound, the smallest diameters in the market by far. In the past, the smallest stuff out there was 40 pound, and that from other people was very difficult to work with, very difficult. In the case of the Torah Tamer product, you could actually get 130 pound line mono inside of that 40 pound. In the case of that 20 and 30 pound, as Larry Daho confirmed, pretty doggone consistent as far as getting 80 pound and greater inside of that line. So for the guys that are fishing high-end reels and don't want to have that problem with a bump coming through the guides that you would get with a knot, you can go hollow core on a small bait caster at 20 or 30 pound on the braid, go drop down to 12 pound or less, or bump it on up on your leader, and you're going to flow through these things with no bumps, nothing. It's just going to zoom right on through. If you're going straight braid on a spinner, this is one way to prevent getting the knots in your line from the wind, as well as increasing your casting distance. Again, to feel these rods is to be believers in how light they are. They do have typical Seeker limited lifetime warranty on them. Their warranty is the best in the business, and Seeker honors it respectfully to their clients. This is good stuff. And price-wise, for this type of technology, I'm seeing some rods from other manufacturers out there that are made overseas. Not to name names, but I think, initials on one was Phoenix, which is not the old Phoenix company of years past that was made in Fountain Valley, California. But the newer Phoenix rods, which come from China, those rods are priced like American-built rods, and it makes no sense to me or anybody else in the industry other than a few retailers that seem to push those. These guys, initial production was produced here in the States. Future production will be produced overseas using these same components and obviously the same blanks. Now, that will reduce the cost down. Seeker's pricing on these rods, which incorporate the best technology in the business, is very, very modest. I think the rods range in length from about 7 feet on up to 8 feet. And the most expensive rods within the series, which share all the same characteristics as any of the other rods, ranges from like $172 down to maybe $150. Priced very, very attractively. Where there are advantages in terms of production costs, the Seeker folks are letting people see those. They're not pocketing that. So the value is there, the warranty is there, the technology of the products is certainly there. These are some very, very nice, very, very nice rods to own. And again, that range and test, they probably go down to 4 pounds, but we're stocking the pieces in anywhere from 6 to 25 pound application. Nice action with the rods in terms of the way they bend. That's something I can't exactly show you very well. I don't think this will translate to video, not very easily. But it's a nice, moderately fast taper to these things. And that diameter is something else. I don't know if you can see this, how doggone skinny these guys are. Let's see here, next to an ink pen. I don't know if you can make that out, maybe with the contrast with my blue shirt, you can see. These are tiny, tiny, tiny diameter blanks. So, super light, strong, great feel from the things. I think Seeker has a winner here, and they didn't price them crazy. It's good stuff. So, that was the other part of our introduction. Thanks for watching the video.